Okay, we're now about 3 weeks away from surgery, so we're having a little hack, but sort of trying to stay off his back as much as possible, really. And so today we're going to do a little bit of our groundwork and have a look and see how he's moving, aren't we? We're really up for it, Orange Pony. Really up for it. Come on then. Quite as willing to bend as he was before his leg injury, especially to the left, a bit reluctant. So I'm going to do a little bit of work and then come back to it and see if it becomes. So might look completely pointless to some people walking around like that, but this one's such a spook head, you know, so it's like, oh, trees are blowing, oh, there's something different over there. The top end is the spooky end. So for him, just to do work where I'm teaching him to just walk, you know, just really chilled with his head down around the outside of the arena is just really good work for him. And I think I might as well, you know, spend the time doing that while I'm not on his back as well. Because, you know, he's been extremely spooky in here. And I tend to use mostly sort of Warwick Schiller's method of letting him rest where in what he thinks is a spooky area, and then when he wants to come away from it, then he works. And it seems to work really well for him, and he knows exactly what's going on now. And, you know, it's lovely when he then eventually will just drop his nose to the floor and just walk the whole way around without questioning anything. So, yeah, it probably seems really pointless and boring to a lot of people, but there's a massive point to it, and I hope it'll serve us really well when I'm back on board as well. Hey, good boy. Come on then, let's go and do some...
Good boy. Come on. Look at that.
A bit more cantering today, which is quite funny. He's used to only doing a little bit of canter, which is why he kept stopping going, surely that's enough. And he didn't stretch down as well today as he normally would in canter, but then since he had his leg injury, he hasn't really been cantering so much. So he's only done a couple of bursts just to see how he was. So hopefully by the time he has surgery, we'll be back to at least stretching down a bit in the canter. He was just a little bit stiff and I didn't want to put any pressure on to try and get him stretching down today by putting him on three tracks. I think he just needs to just canter forward at the moment and just be happy just to at least canter. So I'm going to finish by just taking him for another couple of laps around the school to check that we're all still sane going around the outside, but I'm going to switch off because that's a bit boring for everyone to watch. So just one more thing, just reminded me because somebody just stopped and said how good he looks. So it just reminded me that, good boy, despite the fact that he does work really well and everybody always comments on how good he looks, I'm just hoping that post-surgery, because this is one of the things that worried me about having surgery, was, oh, but he works so well and he looks so good now, you know, hopefully it's not going to make him worse. I'm just hoping that after surgery, know, considering how well he... Can you just stand there and look at, so the camera can look at you, please? Stand there and be admired. That's a good boy. I'm just hoping that post-surgery, this bum will have built up to the same kind of level as everything else has built up, because, you know, he has really built up and he's so much stronger. But I think this should be equal to the rest of it, and this, we should be looking at this coming here and coming out a bit. So I just wanted to just go over just to make sure we can see that. You know, so he does look good and he does work well, but I do think this should really be joining this and matching it a bit more. So I'm hoping that will be an improvement after surgery.